How's it going, peeps? It is now time for the Raw results slash highlights and review video. I'll go over the results, what happened, some highlights in my opinion, and give you guys my thoughts on the show. So, it kicks off with Vickie Guerrero in the ring, and there's a ladder in the ring, and she says the ladder represents her career. And then she climbs up the ladder, and she talks about, you know, her being general manager and how really she had nobody to tell her how to run things or, you know, how to work in a male-dominated environment or whatever. And I think eventually, yeah, she says something along the lines that everything she's done, every decision she's made so far has been for the WWE Universe. And that's when Jerry the King Lawler interrupts her by saying, I've always wanted to say this, but excuse me. And then he's got this paper and he says, I've just been informed that the WWE Universe will get to decide, well, not decide, but have part in what happens to you by deciding if, you know, your run as general manager was a fail or if it passed. You could actually vote on the app. So then Vicky starts kissing up to the fans and starts announcing these matches that she's got playing and these segments. She first announces Mark Henry and John Cena face-to-face tonight. She also announces Daniel Bryan versus Sheamus, which is the upcoming matchup. She announces Christian versus Kane, Randy versus CM Punk, and I think that was it. Pretty sure that was it, although, was it it? Yeah, I think that was it. So, and she says Sheamus versus Daniel Bryan is next. So Daniel Bryan comes out and she gets off the ladder, and Daniel Bryan has this new t-shirt where it's pretty much just face without the eyes. The eyes are covered with a tag that says respect the beard. But anyways, as far as the Sheamus Daniel Bryan match, it was a great, really, really good match. Definitely not an 18 seconds match. Lasted like 15 minutes, maybe even 20. I think it was around 15 minutes. Anyways, great match, like I said. Sheamus did not connect with the bro kick in the matchup. Daniel Bryan did not connect. He was about to lock on the no lock, but he wasn't successful. And towards the end, Sheamus had Daniel Bryan locked on to the, what's it called? The cloverleaf. Yeah, the cloverleaf. He had that locked on to Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan tried getting out of it, but Sheamus put it back on. And then the second time, Daniel Bryan countered it into a small package. 1, 2, 3. Daniel Bryan won the matchup with a roll-up. So I'm really happy Daniel Bryan won that. I was actually expecting maybe Sheamus to pull out a bro kick out of nowhere. I'm happy Daniel Bryan beat Sheamus this time. After the match, they shake hands. And then after that, you have a reporter looking for the Wyatt family or where they live or whatever. And he's looking for instructions. So two random guys tell him it's like 3 miles down the road or something like that this way. And then backstage, you see AJ with Biggie Langston, and she's pretty much telling Biggie to be on the lookout for Kaitlyn. And Biggie says, why are you so worried? You've beat her before, and you'll beat her again. And she says, yeah, but, you know, just in case, whatever, I want to take precautions, blah, blah, blah. And Dolph comes up to them, and he asks Biggie to leave, or he just wants to talk to AJ. He brings up how she didn't come out with him on Raw or SmackDown, but he says it's okay because he beat, you know, he won his matches anyways because he's that good. He talks about the possibility of her being Divas Champion and him being World Champion, and that should be their focus, and how, yeah, their focus should be on them being the champions, the power couple, and him winning back the World Heavyweight Championship. And AJ says, you want to go all the way? And he says, yeah, I want to go all the way to the World Heavyweight Championship, or my third World Heavyweight Championship. And that was pretty much it. And then the Shield come out for a tag team matchup. Their opponents ended up being tons of funk. It was a back and forth matchup. In the end, Roman Reigns tagged himself in without Sweet T seeing and speared Sweet T for the victory. After the matchup, oh yeah, and by the way, they announced that the Usos versus the Shield at Money in the Bank is going to be the Money in the Bank kickoff pre-show. So I guess kickoff is a new, I guess it's the official title for every single pre-show now, not just payback. After that, there was another segment where the reporter is looking for the Wyatt family. I think he's at the house now. And then you see John Cena coming out to the ring because Mark Henry called him out on Twitter, said he was going to call out John Cena. And Mark Henry comes out, and it was a back-and-forth promo, where in the end, he tells John Cena, if you don't stop interrupting me, then Money in the Bank is going to be right now. So John Cena challenges him to, you know, to fight right now. Mark Henry declines and pretends like he's about to leave. But then as soon as John Cena kind of bends over to try and grab the belt or something like that, Mark Henry goes back and attacks John Cena. John Cena then tries to hit the Attitude Adjustment on Henry, but Henry falls on top of John Cena and then hits the World's Strongest Slam on John Cena and holds the championship while John Cena's down. And then you had Randy Orton actually looking on backstage at the John Cena and Mark Henry segments. And he got interviewed by Josh Matthews, and he stated that if he wins at Money in the Bank, he's going to cash it in. If John Cena finds himself vulnerable like that after the match against Mark Henry, he's going to cash it in against John Cena for the title and take it from him. Following that, The Miz is on commentary for Chris Jericho versus Curtis Axel. And towards the end of the matchup, Curtis Axel gets sent to the outside, and The Miz was smiling. So Curtis Axel tells him, "You think that's funny?" And he gets a little bit distracted. And Paul Heyman tells Curtis Axel, get back in the ring, you're going to get counted out. So Curtis Axel finally gets back in the ring, and when he does, Jericho hits him with the Codebreaker, pins him, 1-2-3, wins the matchup. So he's the first guy to defeat Curtis Axel since Curtis Axel returned. And then backstage, we see Josh Matthews along with Team Rhodes Scholars. He asks them, you know, how the Money in the Bank ladder match is going to affect their friendship since they're both in the matchup. And Damien stands out pretty much as that it's not going to affect their friendship. And then he asks Cody the same question, and Damien Sandow started speaking for Cody, but then Antonio Cesaro and Jack Swagger interrupted along with Zeb Coulter, and then Wade Barrett came in, and then pretty much every single person of the matchup, every single person involved in the matchup came in, including Fandango, except for Dean Ambrose. Dean Ambrose was not there. Fandango came in just to say Fandango or Fandango. Every time he tries to say it, somebody interrupts him and tells him, don't say it. Wade Barrett was the first one telling him, don't say it. And then I think Zeb Coulter and then Cody and then pretty much everybody telling him not to say it. So he says it anyways, and Wade Barrett punches him, and they all laugh. And they all leave except for Antonio Cesaro, Jack Swagger, and Cody Rhodes and Damien Sandow, who stare each other down. And after that segment, I believe, was another promo or segment where the reporter is looking for the Wyatt family. And he's finally in the house, and he meets Bray Wyatt. And then after that, Sin Cara faces off against Del Rio in a non-title matchup. The match ends, I believe, in a disqualification, although the referee never rings the bell. Towards the end, you had Dolph Ziggler interfere and mock Del Rio, mock his announcer, and that's when Del Rio got out of the ring and started attacking Dolph Ziggler, and they started fighting, and then eventually Sin Cara jumps from the top turnbuckle onto the outside, onto Del Rio, and yeah, I guess it was a disqualification in favor of Del Rio, but it was never announced. After that, you had the job evaluation for Vickie Guerrero, and Vince McMahon, Triple H, and Stephanie McMahon were all there. They were sitting down, and pretty much to sum up the segment, Vince wanted her to stay, wanted her to be the permanent general manager. Triple H wanted her fired, and Stephanie McMahon was kind of in the middle. So Vince McMahon and Triple H decided to let Stephanie decide. And pretty much Vince McMahon was trying to get Stephanie to side with him, and Triple H trying to get Stephanie to side with him. Eventually Stephanie says, all right, I'm not going to pick a side. Instead, we're going to let the poll results choose what happens to Vicky. And they show the results from the WWE app. And 75% of the fans chose that she failed as a general manager or as a managing supervisor. So she tells Vicky she's fired. Vicky starts screaming. Stephanie and Triple H leave, and Vince McMahon stays in the ring. He grabs the mic, he tells the people, see what you people did. It's all because of you. He blames the WWE Universe for Vickie Guerrero getting fired. And he tells them that he's gonna right this wrong, And he's going to give them a general manager that they deserve. And he names Brad Maddox the new general manager. And Brad Maddox looks kind of confused. He doesn't know what to say. Anyways, after that segment, you see Vince McMahon with Vickie backstage. And he tells Vickie, like, he's going to find a solution. He's going to find a way to make this right. And Brad Maddox comes up to them. And he thanks Vince McMahon for making him GM. And he also tells Vickie he's sorry for what happened. And that he's gonna start off where Vickie left off or whatever. And Vickie snaps and starts hitting Brad Maddox. And oh yeah, before she did that, Brad Maddox was like extending his hand to Vince McMahon so Vince McMahon could shake it. But Vince McMahon did not shake it. And he said, how long are you gonna have this hand extended out for? And he tells Brad Maddox, you know, I gave them the general manager they deserved. So yeah, anyways, Vickie starts attacking Brad Maddox. Brad Maddox goes away. And that was it for that segment. After that, Kane comes out for his matchup against Christian. The end of the match came when Christian went for a spear, but Kane caught him for a choke slam and won the matchup. Right after the match, he saw Bray Wyatt on the Titantron. He lights up a lantern and he says, we're here. They make their entrance. The entrance is like completely dark. There's no lights apart from the lantern. And he sits down while the other two start attacking Kane, who's still in the ring. And they take down Kane. They get him out of the ring. And then they shove him or push him onto the steel steps. And then they grab the other steel steps. And kind of... Kane's got like his head on... like laying on one of on the other steel steps. So they take the other steel step and kind of hit him with it while hit him with it in the head or whatever while he's laying on the other steel steps or his head is laying on it. Kind of hard to explain, but whatever. They take out Kane with that. And then the fans actually started chanting Husky Harris. Husky Harris. So first, it was the Albert chants for Tensai. Now it's the Husky Harris chance for Bray Wyatt. I wonder if they're going to keep chanting that for his future matches. But anyways, then you had a segment backstage where Vickie was leaving. She had a box of her things. And Ryback comes up to her and he hugs her. And then he says she deserves better. So that was kind of weird. I don't know how to expect that. And then you had a tag team match. It was Kaitlyn and Layla versus AJ Lee and Alicia Fox. And I think the match really, it just stopped. They didn't have a win or anything like that. You had Kaitlyn spearing AJ on the outside. And she started attacking her. And then her music hit. So I'm not even sure who won this matchup. If it was a no contest or disqualification. And then you had an interview with CM Punk backstage with Josh Matthews about Randy and his match tonight and Money in the Bank. After that was their actual matchup. That was the main event, CM Punk versus Randy Orton. It was another good matchup. CM Punk won the match with the go to sleep. And after the match, Daniel Bryan came out and started attacking CM Punk. He then threw CM Punk outside the ring. And then he went outside, grabbed the ladder, hit Randy with the ladder, set the ladder up, climbed it, grabbed the Money in the Bank briefcase, and that was the end of Raw. So with that, I think about tonight's show. I thought actually it was a good show. I really enjoyed tonight's Raw. Bunch of good matches. You know, I enjoyed Daniel Bryan versus Sheamus. I enjoyed the main event, CM Punk versus Randy. The Wyatt family debuted. It was all good in my opinion. I was surprised though. Well, not really surprised, but I was hoping Christian would win his matchup because he also lost on Friday against Randy. So I was hoping maybe he'd win his match against Kane, but he lost. So anyways, as far as a rating for tonight's show, actually highlights, the Wyatt family debuted and, I guess the main event, or Daniel Bryan versus Sheamus. Those were two really good matches. And for a rating for the show, I'd give it an 8 out of 10. So, yeah. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, as always, you can click that like button down below. I'd really appreciate it. You can expect a video from me tomorrow. And with that said, I'm out, guys. See ya.